we were talking, Brian, about the beginning, about our ages and when we first met, and we first met at Trident Studios when you were young and I was still an embryo. But we don't sort of, unless you have those reference points, you don't really think about, you know, one's age. But I was talking to Nick Mason the other day, who's, you know, our age, and he was talking about this final Pink Floyd album that's come out.
I've been hearing about it. I can't wait to hear that.
Yeah. And talking about the sort of, you know, one's mortality in the world and everyone around you. And I'm just wondering if those sort of thoughts, you know, occur to you and to Roger as well, that, you know, time passes.
I think we think about mortality quite a lot, really. And hopefully in a healthy way, because it helps to helps you to sort of set up your life and keep an eye on your priorities, doesn't it? You sort of, I think you should be aware of the clock ticking away. And it's a clock which can stop at any point, of course. You know, there's not a finite predicted length to your life. But you know, people like us know that we're more than three quarters of the way through. And what is it that is worth doing for the remaining part? And I think it's a good thing to be aware of.
And what is it for you? Because it's not just music, is it?
No, it isn't just music. To me, it's all about being a rounded human being and doing what you can while you're on the planet, because who knows where you are after that, if anywhere. You know, we have no idea. And I've become very passionate about trying to change the way we treat the other species on this planet. I think there is an evolution going on. In the old days, it was okay to imagine that black people had no feelings, or that women had no right to vote, or it was okay to burn witches at the stake, or indulge in bear baiting and all that sort of stuff. Now, we're at a time when I believe the next step is to move towards treating every animal with respect, very much like the Buddhists and Shinto religion do. But I think the Western world's gone a long way wrong by abusing animals of all kinds. So I spend a lot of my time trying to change that. Mm-hmm. And I've never been a political animal, but I move a lot in political circles now. I maintain my neutrality fiercely. I'm not going to join any political party. But we maneuver, we lobby, we try to open people's eyes, and we spend a lot of our time in the House of Commons just doing that.
Mm-hmm. And around the world as well. But, you know, you are first and foremost a musician. Mm. You're going out on the road in the UK in January. Mm. Musicians have to play. So the fact that you're going out and playing live again with a spectacular show and all sorts of goodies happening, that must be a real excitement for you.
It's great. It's a bonus for me. I really thought we would never be doing this. You know.
Really?
Oh yeah. I remember. I'm thinking. You know, looking at. I obviously would still go to shows and think, well, we used to do that. You know, we used to play in arenas or whatever. And you go to different countries, and I would look at the Tokyo Dome and think, oh, you know, in the old days, well, we might have done that. But that's never going to happen again. But not in I didn't feel it in a terribly sad way. I just thought, you know, we did that, and now we do something different. Suddenly, out of the blue, we are in the same arena again, if I can use the metaphor. And how incredible that we can still do that. People still want to come and fill those arenas, and we can still rock the hell out of them. It's great. I love it. It's very very uplifting. I'm glad that my kids can see it, and even my grandkids can see it now. Yeah, there's a funny moment when one of my grandchildren was talking to his teacher at school, I think, and he said, "Oh, you should hear my granddad's band." You know, and I thought, how do you compute that? You know, who would have thought that would be the
case? And how does that make you feel?
It's weird, you know. I love being a father. You know, when that happened, I was just absolutely full of joy. I love being called Dad. Being called Granddad took a while to get used to, because it does feel like you've sort of suddenly gone into a class of human being that you didn't think you would ever reach. You know, I still find it a little bit hard, but obviously, you know, I love my grandchildren to bits. But, yeah, it's odd. But we're all boys inside, aren't we, Nicky? Really?
We are indeed.
We don't change. That doesn't change. We're still boys. And
one final question. It's Freddie left 23 years ago. In fact, it will be the 23rd anniversary on November the 24th. And since then, the band that he was in has gone on to greater things than I think even he possibly could have imagined during his life. That must be also, for you, looking back at that anniversary, a sense of pride as to what you have done in his name with the band.
Yeah, I feel good about it, and I know he would, and I hope he does in some place. Yeah, we stayed true to our philosophy, to our principles of excellence and being entertainers and speaking the truth. So I'm very pleased. Yeah, there have been so many moments where I thought, you know, if Freddie was here, what would he be thinking? What would he be saying? There's the moment when I played on the roof of Buckingham Palace, you know. If Freddie had been around, I think we would have had Freddie doing something, you know. But we have the legacy, we have the songs, and we have that kind of spiritual connection that people want to experience again. So it's a great thing to be a part of, and I'm sure I'll be doing it until I drop. And, you know, happy, grateful and blessed.
Queen forever. Brian, Dr. Brian May, thank you very much indeed.
Thanks, Nicky.
Thank you.